Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Perfect Sports Nutrition, is the Philly Shell good for mixed martial arts and the UFC? All right, in today's episode, we're gonna break down the Philly Shell and does it work in mixed martial arts? All right, so let's first talk about what is the Philly Shell. So the Philly Shell is, you're gonna realize, is your hands are gonna be in a different position we're used to. Yeah, kickboxing, the traditional hand position. Boxers will maybe put their hands, you know, just under that cheekbone so they can see and move their head. But then there's the Philly Shell. So let's first talk about, why is a Philly Shell used well? Well, the Philly Shell is nice in boxing and stuff here because, one, this hand is down, so it allows you to get different angles and it lets you shoulder roll really well. You know, we saw Floyd Mayweather use this Philly Shell, one of the best ever, right? So how is it used, right? The first thing here is it's nice for counter punching. So Matt can jab, boom, he crosses, boom, and then I could mix in that nice rear hand. So he's here, one, two, bang, if he goes jab, cross, hook, one, two, three, and I got angles. You can see how I'm punching up, right? So does it use well in MMA if someone's boxing you? Yes, of course it does. You know, one of the examples Matt and I were talking about when preparing for this video is Bobby Green. Very good boxer, uses that Philly Shell and uses his head well, right? So it does work. So again, when the punches come, why it is nice, one, look at, my body's protected, right? I could, one, protect body punches, which we don't see enough of in MMA, but that is one of the benefits of the Philly Shell, is covering the body, right? It's very hard to attack. Now, so when we do that though, Matt's gonna do it. So in MMA, it's nice, boom. You're blocking, you're countering, you're moving, you're slipping. Now, what is some of the problems that you're gonna see with that? Is, what is my front foot when I'm in a Philly Shell? It's bladed. How many times do I say a bladed stance is a very dangerous stance? If, okay, it's not dangerous if your opponent doesn't throw low kick. It's only dangerous if my opponent's gonna attack my legs, okay? So if I'm in a Philly Shell and Matt kicks my legs, I might adjust my stance now and I might go a little bit more front foot forward. So now I could block. So that's the first thing. If someone sits in a Philly Shell, right, and they take my legs, I have to adjust. If not though, I love this position, okay? What else is good about the Philly Shell with MMA and the small gloves? Square stance in Muay Thai. Where's my center line? I'm hiding my center line, right? It's very difficult for you to, you know, get to my body, to my face here, right? In that Philly Shell position. Yes, my leg is open and that's where the downside is, but my body's covered, it's hard to hit, very effective. Now, the other thing, my favorite thing about the Philly Shell when it comes to mixed martial arts is, me being a striker, right, is keeping this lead hand a little bit lower. By having this hand lower in my Philly Shell, right, Matt has to kind of dip down to get my single leg or to shoot in. So what I'm gonna do from here, from this Philly Shell, I can bait in and boom, use that lead uppercut really well, right? Or if Matt throws an overhand to come in, boom, bang, I have that option to kind of step out, move my foot really well and punish people for coming in, right? So that is the nice benefit of it. This lead hand low occupies that low line for the person wanting to take you down to make it difficult. If all of my punches are up here, it's very easy for them to get underneath and grab, right? So I need, with this hand here now, it's gonna make, and I'm moving it slightly, it's gonna make Matt think, even if I'm fainting, boom, he's gonna walk into that. So right away, as a striker, the Philly Shell is a very effective way of shutting down the takedown. You need to occupy that space to make the person shooting think twice, right? That's the thing. Now, the other thing about the Philly Shell is, it's really reserved for those with good eyes, all right? Now, as a coach here, and I've been coaching for many years, the biggest thing I see is a lot of these newer fighters watch the best, right? They watch the Floyd Mayweathers. And all of a sudden now they think they're so good and effective at it, and that's when they get hurt. So it is probably, when it comes to mixed martial arts and it comes to kickboxing, I would say it is one of the last types of guards and defenses I teach. I save it for my more advanced fighters because, to me, the better habits are better with structure guard up top. If you want to lower your hands a little bit or keep one hand out here, it's okay. You have to have a lot of confidence in your head movement and your eyes and your timing to fight in the Philly Shell. right? So that's where you'll get a lot of positives. It's great for the striking. It's good to counter punch. It's good to get your head offline. It hides good uppercuts. I could attack on low line angles and low line jabbing where you can't see it. You know, very effective. And if Matt comes in with a nice high guard, right, you can think sitting here, boom, I can attack these sides, block, counter. I can pin this shot here, move, you know, Matt throws a counter shot, boom, I block and I come back in. So it's effective, but I gotta have the eyes and the confidence to be able to play here, okay? So that's the number one thing. So if you're newer, maybe build it in once in a while, but don't always do it, right? There's benefits, right? And there's definitely disadvantages of using the Philly shell. Now, just like any concept, okay, this is what I wanna make sure I leave you with here. Any concept that I teach, right? The success and the failure of it is gonna depend on your opponent and how you set it up, all right? If I'm fighting someone now who's also a low liner, right? And he's keeping his hands down trying to fight, I might wanna use a different guard style. I might wanna play a more high guard so I can chop the leg, you know? If I'm fighting somebody and they're not attacking my leg, I'm gonna put myself in a better punching position to get my knockout, right? I'd rather stand here to hit you with my hands than to hit you with my hands in a more traditional Muay Thai, right? Traditional Muay Thai, I'm a little bit more square. If I kickbox and go with a more boxing bladed stance, now I could really pivot and generate power, right? So you need to understand that, yes, you have to have a style and a way, but different ways work. You have to have the ability to adjust. So my biggest recommendation here at this end of this video is have a structure and a base with other types of defense. So that means my high guard's gotta be sharp. Your parrying needs to be impeccable. But there might be times where I might use high guard, parry, and then quickly for a moment, I might be setting things up. I might want an upper gut or a nice counter shot or a nice low line shot. Right? Those are all things you want to do, right? So all different things. Now, if someone does give you an Philly shell, right? Matt's in a Philly shell, what do I do, right? If he's moving and evading the leg, the idea is taking angles, right? So when you see someone in a Philly shell, look to attack the body to the head, right? The body's protected, right? So it's very difficult. So what I want to do is I want to make sure I punch and try to come on these angles, right? Try to beat them up on angles, chop the leg, and then try to get the finish there, okay? So remember, benefits and disadvantages of the Philly shell. Make sure you understand that it might work, it might not, but the key, the better of the martial artist is gonna have the ability to adapt and change if it's unsuccessful. All right, like, subscribe, share, do all those fun things that you do here on YouTube. Make sure you, one, go to the channel sponsors, Perfect Sports Nutrition, use code BAZOOKA20 to get 20% off your supplements. We have Hayabusa, go to Hayabusa Fight for all their sick Hayabusa gear that Maddie and I are rocking in these videos. We have BAZOOKATraining.com, right? For only $9.99 a month, yes, that's right, less than $10 a month, you're getting 4 videos a week, 4 brand new videos a week, sparring drills, tutorials, home drills, bag drills, every Monday, 4 videos to help you learn. This video here, you learned a little bit about defense, but I have a whole defensive system, counters, counter the counter, 2 combo drills. The whole system, the curriculum is at bazookatraining.com. Learn the general idea here and then perfect it by going to bazookatraining.com. Like I said, under 10 bucks a month. If you like any of the gear too, you can go to bazookashop.com and sport some of the bazooka gear at your gym. All right, we'll see you next time here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Welcome to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA Online Training. I'm Bazooka Joe Veltellini, the owner here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Over the past year, I've designed and created a website to teach Bazooka curriculum at home and across the world. The purpose of this website is for you to, one, hit your fitness and health goals, all while learning world-class martial arts instruction from me. The beautiful thing about this website, it's geared for all levels. So if you're learning martial arts for the first time as a beginner, we help you progress into the bigger stages. And if you're a pro fighter, guess what? We have different fight concepts for you to improve your tool set and your skills in the ring or cage. As the fastest rising kickboxing world champion and a lifelong martial artist with over 30 years of experience, I've been able to combine my passion for martial arts and teaching to create this website. This website's gonna give you some of the tricks, secrets, and inside look at some of the training I use to win my world title. Once you subscribe to the site, you're going to be getting weekly training videos and tutorials that you can do from anywhere. The sections are broken up into three parts. The first is bag workout. So if you have a bag at home or at your gym, you can use these workouts to supplement your training. The second is at-home workouts. A lot of us don't have the room for a bag or a bag in general, so these workouts are for no equipment needed and you can do them anywhere. And finally, the tutorial section. If you're having any problems with a specific technique or fight concept that's covered in any of the workouts, go to the tutorial section, learn the technique, and then go back to the workout, and this time, do it with proper technique. One of the added benefits once you subscribe is the forum section, where you can get a more personalized experience where you can ask questions and I'll be able to go in there and answer them. It's all about building a team and a community of martial artists helping each other grow. So subscribe now to get access to all the videos plus more so you can be part of the squad here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.